Hello everyone, in this video we will be solving UGC in a December 2013 question paper. If you want to check out our courses, then you can go to our website, which is www.digimento.com. Over there you can go to the courses section. In courses section you can check out our comprehensive courses for GATE, UGC NET and placement preparation. Currently we are offering huge discounts on UGC NET computer science video lecture subscription and test series. So if you want to enroll to our video lectures and subscription and test series, you can always visit our website and please call on the numbers below. Please don't forget to like and share the videos with your friend.
Hello everyone, welcome to the GateLectures.com. So in today's session, I'm going to solve UGC NET paper 2, and this paper was conducted in December 2013. So now let's start. This is the question number 1. When data and an acknowledgement are sent in the same frame, that is called as option A is big. Packing, piggybacking, backpacking or good packing, right? Now we know that, let's suppose this is the sender and this system is receiver, okay? And you know about the full duplex mode. The full duplex mode is a bidirectional, right? It's a bidirectional, so it's like, or you can draw this channel like this also. Like, first we draw the data, first we transmit the data from this channel, and then we, this receiver acknowledge with this channel. So this is a bidirectional channel, right? So in the full duplex mode, we know that the transmission of data needs to be bidirectional. So in this full duplex mode, we have two modes. One is for we have two separate channels, one for the data transmission and one for the acknowledgement, right? But in the piggybacking is, it's a piggybacking, it's a technique when we sent data plus acknowledgement within the same frame. So what is the advantage for this, for piggybacking? Is advantage isse kya hogi ki isse better usage of the channel. Yes, better usage of channel. Isme ye nahi hoga ki first hum transmit kare data, then we transmit the transmit back acknowledgement. So इसमें क्या होगा कि हम एक ही at one time हम data भी send कर देंगे और acknowledgement भी send कर देंगे, तो we need only one channel. We don't need two channels, like first हम transmit करें then we transmit back acknowledgement. So we need only one channel. So इससे क्या होगा कि better usage of channel है, but there is one disadvantage is also. Disadvantage क्या होगी कि complexity increase होगी, addition of complexity. Yes, क्योंकि अगर हम एक frame में सिर्फ, अगर हम सिर्फ data send कर रहे हैं, तो that will be quite simple, but उसमें फिर हम acknowledgement भी डाल के दे रहे हैं, तो complexity of the frame is going to be increased. So this is a disadvantage and this is the advantage of piggybacking. So correct answer is B. Now question number 2 is, encryption and decryption is the responsibility of which layer? Physical network application layer and data link layer. So you know about the models, TCP/IP model and the OSI model, right? Now you know that in the OSI model we have 7 layers, like application layer, then we have presentation layer, then we have session layer, then we have transport layer, then network layer, then data link layer, and then physical layer. But in the TCP/IP model we have only four layers: application layer, transport layer, network layer, data link layer, physical layer. So these layers are present in the TCP/IP model, but in this OSI model we have 7 layers, in this we have 5 layers. So these two layers are not present in the TCP/IP. So basically in the OSI model, the presentation layer functionality is to encrypt the message or to decrypt the message, right? So it's the responsibility of the presentation layer in the OSI model. But in the TCP/IP model, no presentation layer, no session layer is there. So presentation layer nahi hai. So in this case, application layer hi is responsibility ko fulfill karega ki wo encrypt bhi karega message ko and decrypt bhi karega. So this is the responsibility of application layer in the TCP/IP model. Or if we talk about the OSI model, usme hum kya karenge ki usme presentation layer ki ye responsibility, is responsibility ko hum presentation layer ko de dete hain ki aap encrypt karoge message ko aur first then receiver ke paas jab ye data aise jayega to yahan par ye presentation layer hogi to yahan par wo decrypt karke ye message application layer ko provide karega. But you can see that in the options they are not mentioned about whether we are using the TCP/IP model or we are using the OSI model. But look at the options. Physical layer ki to responsibility hai nahi. Network layer ki it's not. Next is data link layer. No, so left one is application layer. So it means no presentation layer is given. So they are talking about the TCP/IP model. So option C is the right one. Question number third is an analog signal carries 4 bits in each signal unit. If 1000 signal units are sent per second, then baud rate and bit rate of the signals are. Now, so this is a 4 bits in each signal unit. So it means it is a number of bits per second is going to be 4, and they said if 1000 signal units are sent per second, so this is a signal rate. Now the signal rate, or we can say that baud rate, it's same thing. So signal rate is 1000 signal units per second. So it is already given. Then we have to tell the baud rate and the bit rate of the signal is how much. Now, you know that baud rate is equal to bit rate divided by number of bits per second. So signal rate is 1000. So we signal rate and baud rate is same thing. So baud rate, then baud rate and bit rate of the signal are, so baud rate is 1000 bits and the bit rate is, so we know that baud rate, so baud rate value, put the value of baud rate is 1000 and then cross multiply. So this is number of bits per second is already given, it's 4. So bit rate is equal to 4000 bits per second. This is our bit rate. Okay, so option number D is the right one. Now question number 4 is the VLF and the LF boards use propagation of for communication is ground, sky, line of sight and space. So this is a very, the full form is VLF is very low frequency, and the full form of LF is low frequency. So they are talking about the very low frequency boards and low frequency boards, and they are asking us ki hum in very low frequency mein, low frequency mein hum which propagation method we are using for the communication purpose. So we have different propagation methods, like we have ground, sky, line of sight and space. So these are some propagation methods. Now let's talk about ground propagation method. So in the ground propagation method, the frequency range is equal to, okay, I'm writing here. So the frequency range for ground is 3 to 300 kilohertz, and for sky the frequency range is around 3 to 300 megahertz, and for the line of sight is 300 to 300 gigahertz. So for space, all the frequencies which are above from this range, for all frequency we are using the space propagation method, right? Now, so this is a frequency range. You know that this is a very low frequency, this is a medium level frequency range, and you can say this is the high frequency range and this is the very high frequency range. So in the ground, if this is a ground and these are the antennas, okay, so we in the ground propagation method, you know, the radio waves travel through the lowest portion of the atmosphere, because radio waves has very low frequency range. It's around 300 to 300 kilohertz. So they travel through the lowest portion of the atmosphere. So these low frequency signals travel in, you know, all the directions from the transmitting antennas, right? Now for sky propagation method, this is the range 300 to 300 megahertz, and let's suppose this is the earth and these are the antennas. You know that there is a, after this, you know, this if this is the earth, so there is an ionosphere layer, atmospheric layer is ionosphere layer. So when we transmit the signal, it's go like this, back and forth, and finally reach to this particular antenna. Okay, so this is about sky propagation method, and the line of sight propagation method, if this is earth, so both the antennas are present at the line of sight of each other, so that, you know, signal travel directly to from this antenna to this antenna. So for space, there is an example of the satellite is there, right? So now come back to our question. So according to the question, they are asking the very low frequency and low frequency bands use propagation method for communication is, now you know that this is the ground propagation method. So option A is the right one. Okay. Question number 5 is, using the RSA public key cryptography system, if P value is given, Q is there, D is 7, and then the value of E is what? You know that RSA is a asymmetric crypto algorithm. So what do you understand by asymmetric crypto algorithm? It means that we are using, for encryption, for the decryption purpose, we are using the different keys for different keys like public key and private key. If you talk about the symmetric cryptography, then in that case we are using only one key for encryption and for decryption purpose, but for asymmetric we are using the different keys for encryption and decryption, public and the private key. Now so the RSA algorithm are used to generate two keys. First is generate public key, and second is this algorithm used to generate private key. Okay, private key. Now, so to generate a public key, what we want? We have to select, first step is we have to select two prime numbers. So this is the first step, and this step is common for both keys, for public key and for the private key also. We have to select P and we have to select Q, but in our question P and Q value is already given, so P value is 13. There is no need to select, and q value is 31. Okay, so first step is going to be over. Now the next step is second step, and this step is common for is not common for both keys. So second step is calculate n value, so n is equal to p into q, and in this case, in the private key, for the private key we are calculating phi n, and that phi n is equal to p minus 1 into q minus 1. Okay, q minus 1. So n value is p into q. Now p value is 13 and q value is 31. Okay, and phi n is equal to p minus 1 is 12 and q minus 1 is 30, so this will be equal to 360. Okay, So third step is to generate public key, we want two things. First is E and the second thing is N. We have already calculated N with the help of P into Q, and we have to select E, and we select E in such a manner that it should not be a factor of N. Okay, this is how we calculate the value of E. And the third step for private key is to generate a private key we also need two things. First one is D and the second thing is phi n we already calculate, but we have to calculate value of D. So that value of D is equal to K into phi n plus 1 divided by me E. Now if we know the value of E, we can calculate value of D, right? And according to this, according, you know, ki ye puri ki puri term, you know, going to be divided by E, so according to this we are going to choose the value of K. Okay, so this is how we calculate or we generate public key and private key with the help of RSA algorithm. So now let's come back to our question. So in the question, P value is given, Q value is given, D value is given. So just put all the values in this. Now we are going to be cross multiply because E is not given, D is given. So E is here and D is so this is K multiply Fn and this is plus 1 and this is D. So phi n value is 360 plus 1 divided by D. So D value is D value is already given. This is 7. So if I put value of K is equal to 1, if I put K is equal to 1, then this whole number is not going to be divided by 7. So that's why I choose value of K is equal to 2. Now this will be equal to 720, and then 720 plus 1 is 721, and if we divide by 7, then we got the answer 103. So B is the right answer. Question number 6 is fan in of a component A is defined as. Okay, let's discuss about fan in, where we are using this fan in, then we will discuss and then we'll come back to our question. So fan in and fan out. Fan in and fan out, basically they are the structural matrices which measure inter-module complexities. Okay, so this is we have already discussed cyclomatic complexity, cohesion, coupling. So all these are, you know, some software matrices. Software matrices kya hota hai ki jab bhi hum kisi bhi product ko kisi bhi software ko agar hum banate hain to hum uski, you know, quality ko improve karne ke liye jo industries mein already defined benchmarks hain unse hum apne software ko compare karte hain, and we check ki hamara software कितना ठीक है, कहाँ पर इम्प्रूवमेंट रिक्वायर्ड है, और कितना उन बेंचमार्क्स जो ऑलरेडी फीचर्स गिवन है तो उनको कितना वो फुलफिल कर पा रहा है. सो दैट्स व्हाई टू इन्हेंस द क्वालिटी ऑफ द प्रोडक्ट वी यूज दिस सॉफ्टवेयर मैट्रिसेस. जैसे साइक्लोमेटिक कॉम्प्लेक्सिटी में हम कंट्रोल फ्लो ऑफ अ प्रोग्राम को चेक करते हैं, और हम चेक करते हैं कॉम्प्लेक्सिटी ऑफ अ प्रोग्राम विद द हेल्प ऑफ साइक्लोमेटिक कॉम्प्लेक्सिटी मैट्रिसेस. लाइकवाइज वी आर यूजिंग कोहेजन, जिसमें हम मॉड्यूल्स के अंदर जो एलिमेंट्स है कैसे वो कनेक्टेड है उसे, उसकी कनेक्टिविटी को चेक करते हैं. कपलिंग्स हम डिफरेंट मॉड्यूल्स के बीच में चेक करते हैं. तो इन द सेम वे फैन इन एंड फैन आउट इज स्ट्रक्चरल मैट्रिसेस विच मेजर द इंटर मॉड्यूल कॉम्प्लेक्सिटीज. आई एम राइटिंग हियर फैन इन एंड फैन आउट इज अ स्ट्रक्चरल मैट्रिसेस विच मेजर्स which measures inter-module complexities. Okay, now, so fan-in, if we specifically talk about fan-in and fan-out, so fan-in is, just write it down, number of modules that call a given module. Like suppose this is a modules B, C and D, and all these modules calling a particular module A. So this is a fan in, and this fan out is number of modules that are called by a given module, called by a given module. Like if this is A, so all the modules which are called by this given module A. So you can also say that the fan in is a multiple classes inherits one class, and in the fan out the number of classes inherited by the one class. Okay, so these matrices like fan in and fan out, basically these matrices can apply both at module level and function level. As I already told you that these matrices measure the inter-module complexities. So these matrices, fan in and fan out, are just a number. How complex is interlinking of different module or functions? So I'm writing here, these matrices are just a number, on how complex is interlinking of different module or different functions, right? It's unlike the cyclomatic complexity, just may when you find that cyclomatic complexity of any control graph, any control flow of program. So in that, if the value is in between the range of 1 to 10, then you easily say that yes, our software is in a low risk. Agar value 11 to 20 ke beech mein aa jata, you say that the average is that there is an average risk of the software. But in this matrices, they are just give the size, how difficult it will be to replace a function or module in your application, or how changes to the module can impact the other functionality. Because फैन इन एंड फैन आउट क्या करता है कि अगर टू मॉड्यूल्स की इंटरलिंकिंग के बारे में वो आपको बताते हैं कि कितने कॉम्प्लेक्स हैं उनकी इंटरलिंकिंग, क्योंकि अगर कोई चेंजेस आए तो कितना डिफिकल्ट होगा उन चेंजेस को मॉडिफाई करने में, राइट? कितना वो इम्पैक्ट डालेंगे और कितना डिफिकल्ट रहेगा रिप्लेस करना किसी मॉड्यूल को, बिकॉज दे आर इंटरलिंक्ड विद ईच अदर. सो ऑल दीज थिंग्स आर टेल अबाउट द फैन इन एंड फैन आउट. नाउ कम बैक टू अवर क्वेश्चन. So fan in of a component is defined as number of components can pass or pass control to a component A, right? So this is the correct answer, because number of components that can call or pass control to a component A. So option A is the right one. Okay, number of components that called by component A is fan out, right? Now question number 7 is, the relationship of data elements in a module is called coupling, modularity, cohesion or granularity. Let's talk about two terms. The first one is coupling and the second one is cohesion. Now coupling is how two modules are interconnected with each other, whether they are strongly coupled or whether they are loosely coupled. But for better software, we want low coupling. Why we want low coupling? Because if two modules are strongly connected to each other, because if there is some modification we required, or agar hame kuch is module ko agar hame replace karna hua, then it's very difficult, right? Agar software ek bari ready ho gaya to usme koi changes agar aapko leke aane hain ya koi module ko replace karna hai, then it will be very difficult for you, right? So that's why we want low coupling. And cohesion is, if this is a module, right? So cohesion tell us degree to which all the elements of a module are functionally related to each other. Okay, how strongly they are, how these elements are connected to each other, right? So we also have two types of cohesion. High cohesion, ki kitna zyada, kitna strongly all the elements within a module are connected, or low coupling. Low cohesion is how loosely all the elements present in the module connected to each other. Now for a better software we want high cohesion. There should be a high cohesion between the you know, between the elements, right? It is a desirable because we want one module provide any particular functionality, then every element present in a module provides this functionality, right? So सबके सब एक जैसे functionality को follow करें, so that's why we want कि उनके बीच में एक strong connection हो. So this will tell us by cohesion, और coupling हमें low चाहिए, क्योंकि अगर कोई modification अगर हमें चाहिए, कोई replacement अगर चाहिए, तो उसके लिए हम easily अपने module को वहाँ से हटा सके, तो इसलिए हमें लॉ कपलिंग चाहिए. सो दे सेड दैट रिलेशनशिप ऑफ डेटा एलिमेंट्स इन अ मॉड्यूल, एक मॉड्यूल के अंदर रिलेशनशिप्स के बारे में कौन बताता है बिटवीन द डेटा एलिमेंट्स, वो हमें बताता है कोहेजन. ओके, क्वेश्चन नंबर 8 इज सॉफ्टवेयर कॉन्फ़िगरेशन मैनेजमेंट, द शॉर्ट फॉर्म इज SCM, इज द डिसिप्लिन फॉर सिस्टमेटिकली कंट्रोलिंग the changes due to the evaluation of product as a project proceeds. Option B is the changes due to defects being found and then fixed, and the third one is the changes due to requirement changes. So basically SCM is a task, software configuration management is a task of tracking and controlling the changes in software. Let's suppose user identified after delivery of, you know, software, user identifies some problem or some bug. Okay, so this is a phase when identification and tracing is done by user or by system. Okay, now so this is now going to for analysis. In this phase, you know, the cost of modification is analyzed and estimated. कि हमें कितना you know cost और लगेगी उसे modify करने में या फिर उसे change करने में, so that वो error को हम, उस bug को हम remove कर सकें. Then after the analysis phase, it goes to the design phase. In the design phase, new modules need to be replaced and designed. Earlier, let's suppose some modules are there and they are connected to each other. As I already told you that modules ke beech mein low coupling hona bahut zaruri hai for better quality software. Because yahan par deliver karne ke baad yahan error feel hua, yahan error user ko trace hua. So in this situation, in the design phase, we are going to replace this. Let's suppose they find error in this module. So in this module, if they find error, so they want to replace this module and replace it with a new module. So this kind of, you know, work is in this phase, design phase. And the next one is implementation phase. So in the implementation phase, new module code and your unit testing is done. Then system testing, right? We test the whole system. After that, acceptance testing. We have already discussed about this type of testing. This is basically of two types, alpha testing and beta testing. Alpha testing at the working environment and the, you know, in our office, or beta testing at the user environment, jahan wo after, you know, after the delivery of the product. So at the user environment, whether it's a beta testing or alpha testing, after the completion of the acceptance testing, we finally delivered the product, and after that same maintenance activity is going to be done. So now come back to our question. Let's read all the options one by one. Option A is the changes due to the evaluation of work products as a project proceeds. Yes, this is a responsibility of SCM. Next is the change due to the bugs being found and then fixed. Yes, bugs user ko mile ya fir system ko mile, so the maintenance team is going to be fix it. Again, the same procedure is going to be followed. And the next is the changes due to the requirement changes. Requirement mein koi bhi changes aaya, to us case mein fir se hum kya karenge, dobara se module ki changes honge, and all kind of changes is done by the SCM team. So option D is the right one. All the systematically things are systematically done by the SCM. Okay, now